Are you still asking what time works for you in your emails? If so, stop it. Gmail now has a built-in feature which makes scheduling meetings so much faster and easier. So let me show you how it works. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to simplify your tools and grow your business. And in this case, I want to reach out and follow up with someone and hopefully schedule a meeting this week. But I know this question is the kiss of death, because then they have to give me some suggestions, which will probably not work with my schedule. And then I'll give them some further suggestions, which won't work with their schedule. And then someone will have to manually create an event on their calendar. Well, Gmail makes it super easy for us. So instead of typing in my specific dates, they can just select the specific dates and create the event in one go. We're going to come all the way down to the bottom. This is to the right of the send button and select more options. And the very last option is called set up a time to meet. And then we are given three more options. We actually want the middle one here, propose times you're free. By selecting this, this is actually going to automatically open up your calendar preview here on the right-hand side. And then within your email, we still have the body of the email, which we wrote. It's going to leave a bit of a placeholder. So it's giving us direction, select times in the calendar sidebar for a one-on-one event. So there are two components here. First, we have our mini calendar. So it's starting with today, and then we can toggle over to tomorrow or pick other days in the future. And then down below is where we specify the length of time. What is going to be the duration of that meeting? So let's say I don't want to meet today, but I do have some availability tomorrow. All I need to do is click and drag the amount of time I'm available between 1 and 4, and it's going to reserve this block of time. Now, you'll notice it has broken it down into chunks of 30 minutes. The reason being is that that is my default event time within Google Calendar. But don't worry, you can change that. Maybe I know this needs to be a 1 hour meeting. I'm gonna come down here to this drop down and I'm gonna select 1 hour. You can see I'm still available between 1 and 4, but now there are essentially three slots, right? 3 1-hour slots. Then I'm gonna go over to maybe Wednesday and say that, you know what, Wednesday morning, I'm also gonna be available between 10 and 12, okay? Now, in the other area down below, this is where we selected the length of time. We can continue to scroll down, and it's going to show us what we have selected. It's sort of giving us a summary. So I'm saying I'm available from these hours on the 18th and these hours on the 19th. If I need to delete them or change them, I can add another period on this day, or if I want to remove it, I can do that so here. But at this point, I'm gonna select next. And here, it's gonna keep that summary. It's gonna keep those dates available. But at the top, I can give this a title. So in this example, I'm gonna call this one Budget Review. That's gonna be the name of this event. And then down below, I can even add other details as well. So for example, if I want to add conferencing information, I can immediately add a Google Meet link. I can say it's going to be an in-person meeting and add an address. I can say it's going to be a phone call, and that will force the other user to include their phone number. Or I can just say, you know what, we'll figure this out later. I'm going to leave it at none at this point. I can also add a description if I like. Now, this is not required either, but it can be helpful in case someone is not exactly clear why we are meeting, or if they want to be reminded of that when they go to open up that event. Our last step, once we're happy with everything here, is to select Add to Email. That is going to close the sidebar menu, and then this is what's input into our message. Again, the body of the email has remained the same, but now down below, they see the different times which I am available. When I go ahead and send this email, my recipient will be able to book one of these times in real time with just one click. No more back and forth, no more having to try and figure out when we are both available. Now, if you found this Gmail tip helpful, be sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe right here to the Simpletivity channel. And if you have further questions on how to get the most out of Gmail, be sure to leave a comment for me down below. Thanks so much for watching, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.